We shall now complete the remainder of the search page. We have already seen how IntelliSense or autocomplete it appears when user types something in the email box, and we'll now complete the remainder of the search page HTML, and then we'll proceed on to add the C# code. So what we are going to add is, we have to present. So we have to do two things. The first will be for the user info that appears, and there should be an edit hyperlink, and the second will be the invoice part. The invoice is generated for the user so far, a new invoice hyperlink, and in the list of invoices that already appears, an edit button against each should be there. Now this page can be reached in two ways. First is a GET request for an empty form, that is no query string. The second is a GET request that comes with a query string. When the GET request comes without a query string, in that case no data is passed to this view, only an empty form is to be shown. This means in that case neither this and nor this should appear. So this provision we have to make in this, and what will be the criterion for this? When you get an empty GET request, your model will not contain anything. It will be an empty model that will be coming. So we'll test whether the properties of model are available or not. If these respective properties are not there, then that means that an empty model is coming, and in case the properties are there, then we'll display this. So a conditional if will be used. With this, we were here the last time. We have written the autocomplete script and saw autocomplete working also. Now we are retyping the remaining portions of this page. Let us do so. If null is not equal to model.user, this means if model is empty, then you should show enter a customer email to get details. Something like this one, enter a customer. So in case nothing comes in, and you can see query string is not there, and then this one is a hyperlink for edit, and we are going to create an edit customer action method later on when we deal with this edit. So we provisionally we have made some provision here. This is the edit that will appear. So what is this? This arrow is what I mean. So we can start typing now the table for the user info. Name, phone. So this is the table that will ultimately present the name and phone of the user. who has been searched. You will get the source code as well as the book along with these videos. So right next net, let us now do similar thing for the orders. And what we are doing is we have to present a table having edit buttons and an hyperlink for the issue new invoice. So we can type it quickly. This is the new invoice. Later on we'll add index method to an invoice controller and pass the ID of the user for whom a new invoice is being generated. We have kept a provision here. Order number, date, item, amount, and this edit. This is the header stack, and for each the action link will be displaying edit. Edit invoice will be an action method inside invoice controller to which we'll pass the ID of the invoice which is to be edited. So with this our story is complete. This is the entire CSHTML for the search customer page. Now we have to code this one, search customer controller, and inside the index action we have to write the code that sends us the search view model field for display on this page. That is, we have to write our code into this block. Bring it into view and let us start writing. What is the parameter that will come into this? Let us first have a look at that. This input method will send a parameter called email to search. When the get method is called. And we also agree that when we call this method, when we post a get request to this page, we'll send it in a query string by this name. If that is there, then we can set a parameter of the same name here. This one. So when this page will be sent, when this get request will be sent to this index action, the data that will come would be, because there is only one input element in this whole block, we'll get the data in the email to search parameter, and we have matched it here. Search the TBL order. If email to search is not null, then we will fill, otherwise we'll not fill our model. This is the search single or default finding the TBL user. If the user is there, then search for the product data, that is search the invoices. And finally fill the view model. User and orders will be null if email to search is not there. And then we can pass this C search view model into our view. So basically what we have done is, based on what is coming, we have filled C search view model, and we have taken a lot of care to null test at almost every point. Now we can run it to see what we get. Click to login, search. This is the enter a customer email to get details, because as we put a guard there for null. Click this one and click search. So the data has actually appeared. The edit button is there. Whatever small data we wanted for the customer is there. Order history is there, new invoice, and edit. So search is working. And in our next modules, we'll write code for edit, new invoice, edit. So that is the roadmap we have ahead. We'll close it right now. Thanks.